fail to see the difference between Somogyi effect and down phenomenon or down effect. The Somogyi effect is the patient has a rebound hyperglycemia after hypoglycemia due to insulin intake in the night. So the patient takes insulin in the night, has hypoglycemia in the night, but at the morning there is the rebounding hyperglycemia because there is no longer the effect of insulin. We don't see this anymore because we use now glycine insulin. The down effect or down phenomenon is quite the opposite. The patient has hyperglycemia due to not using insulin. In the morning we have our cortisol spike, and this spike increases the glucose. So here we have hyperglycemia due to contraregulatory hormones of insulin, which is cortisol, epinephrine, growth hormone, etc. So we have increased glucose in the morning due to our spike in cortisol. This would have come if the patient has taken insulin. So if we see patient with down effect, we give insulin at night in order to have the effect of the insulin. But be careful not that now we don't provoke a Somogyi effect. So we need to see if the patient is taking insulin or not. If the patient is taking insulin and in the morning has the hyperglycemia, there will be Somogyi effect. If the patient is not taking insulin and the increasing in glucose is due to the cortisol spike, then it is down effect. The treatment is to use insulin. In both, the treatment is to use insulin, jarring insulin, because jarring insulin has a long effect. So here we will not see now this spike of hypoglycemia and hyperglycemia because we would have the continuous effect of insulin. And here the insulin would contract this cortisol effect. So in both is to use insulin, jarring insulin.